We've got two speakers left, and I'm really pleased to announce that we have Bill Corcoran from the Tyneside Irish Cultural Centre coming to talk about, let's face it, the most important issue of all, the Irish border. So thanks very much, Bill.
Thanks, everybody. I'd like to thank the police for being here and facilitating today in safety and security. I'd like to thank the organisers of this rally who have taken the trouble to ask the Tyneside Irish community to consider our options. Well, everybody's mentioned it. If you look at the instructions to politicians, right next to the one that says don't let children play with matches, it says don't build hard borders through countries. It's stupid. 1900 years ago, somebody built a hard border down there on Westgate Road. It was the bloody Romans. It didn't work out too well for them. They got sent back to where they came from. It took us a couple of hundred years, but we did it. 1961, they built a hard border through Germany. Willy Brandt was here, coincidentally, looking at the Roman wall. And he said, walls never solve anything. Now they tell us that there'll be a fantasy frontier, a bogus border in Ireland, where people can just walk through. There won't be cameras, there won't be inspection pits, won't be walls, won't be barbed wire, won't be ditches, won't be anything. Why bother them? When people move a herd of sheep from one field to another to take advantage of an upsurge in euro prices that month, or when people walk across it simply because they think, all right, well, there's no checks. What was all that stuff about taking control of borders? I don't know, does anybody remember that? Anyway, they'll just walk across, and then somebody will go, this bogus border, this fake frontier is not working, let's build a proper one. Good work for the bricklayers, isn't it? And then we'll have the same tiresome nonsense. The same things that's infected Irish politics for decades. Now, I don't know if any of you remember last weekend, when it was winter, on a little thing called St. Patrick's Day here. St. Patrick's Day is the second biggest cultural celebration in this city after Christmas. It's a long way down, but still, you know, a bit bigger than Chinese New Year still. We're creeping onto that one. We are probably the only Irish community that have a military remembrance service for the Tyneside Irish Brigade and the Northumberland Fusiliers. And after that, we have our guests and friends from the Northumberland Fusiliers and the Royal Regiment of Fusiliers in the Irish Centre afterwards. And they come along wearing their medals with their uniforms on, and we had representatives from the unions community in South Tyneside with the Deputy Lieutenant and the Lord Mayor. And it's a very beautiful show of international friendliness. We give shamrocks out to our friends from many European and world countries, from Bavaria to Bratislava, from Azerbaijan to Zambia. Whoever wants to come gets a shamrock. They're all dead now, by the way. They all die after 3 days. It's and another problem with Brexit. Since Brexit, it's cost us €3 for each shamrock. It used to be a pound a pop, not anymore. And 50 of those lads, there was a rugby match. I don't know if anybody remembered that, when Ireland won. And our friends in the army stood to attention when God said the Queen was on. Not a flicker of a problem. Friendliness, decency, a commonwealth of dignity that we have in this city, that we absorb with our mother's milk, that we breathe in the air around us, that gives us our football team, our friendliness, our community, everything about us. But at the same time, remember, we've got divisions in this community. Before each football match, we're collecting for a food bank. Because, you know, I think there was a foreign minister who said that the Irish border was going to be like going from one London borough to the next. Well, if you go from Jesmond to Walker, life expectancy comes down by 20 years. It's not surprising that when people are in zero-hour contracts, having to go to a food bank, for God's sakes, to ask for food, having to walk to Benwell, 6 miles sometimes, if that food bank won't deal with you because of Trussell Trust rules, to the one in Benwell, and then 6 miles back for a couple of carrier bags of food. It's not surprising that those people want to kick the table over. So remember the decisions made by governments over the last 10 years, why we have that kind of division in our cities, in our country. And let's try and remember the futility of a hard Irish border, the stupidity of that. We celebrate many things, Last year it was 50 years since Martin Luther King Jr. came and got his doctorate. This year it's 50 years since 1968, when I think it was the only year a British soldier wasn't killed in combat operations. 1969, one was killed in Northern Ireland. We don't ever want that. There's a remembrance bench along the road in Eldon Square for the men who served in Northern Ireland, and some of them died. And think about their families. Nobody from this city wants to have to go through that again. Nobody in the Irish community wants to listen to the news and think, my God, there's a bomb gone off. Oh, Jesus Christ. Please, God, let nobody be hurt. And to think about the sickness that infects people when they're cut apart in that way. So please keep this issue at the top of the news. It's not just Ireland, it's Gibraltar, it's other things. And, you know, really, I don't care what they call it, but let's not have hard borders. Remember what happened to the Romans. And thank you for all your help here. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Bill. It's the most important issue of all regarding Brexit. And that's